Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Operations Research. This is Module 2, Transportation Model, and this is lecture number 1 in the Module 2. So, in the Transportation Model, we are going to discuss the basic feasible solution, optimum solution and problem solving in the transportation problem. At the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problems in the transportation model. These are all the some of the images of the transportation of product, semi-finished product, raw material or any goods transported from one place to another place. So, the mode of transport may be different and all the routes, the route via sea cargo ship, the route via train using the container and using the air transportation and using the road transportation, using all the modes of transportation, the goods are transported from one place to another place based on the requirement, based on the demand of a particular item or the product or the goods. The transporting item from warehouse to retail shop, that is one example. So, from the storage place, warehouse is the place where we store large quantity of certain item. So, from the warehouse, we transport the item or the goods to the retail shop for selling purpose. Or in general, transporting items from the source to the destination. The source may be the factory where the products are produced, the source may be the warehouse, the source may be the harbor, or the destination may be the retail shop, destination may be the warehouse. So, from one place to another place, the goods are transported. So, when you transport, the cost is involved, the cost of transportation. So, the main objective of the solution of the transportation model is to minimize the transportation cost. So, we have to identify the shortest route and we have to minimize the cost of transportation from the source to the destination. So, mathematically the transportation model is expressed like this: minimize Cj sigma I equal to 1 to m and j equal to 1 to n Cij multiplied by Xij, where Cij is the unit cost of transportation from the source to the destination, cost of transporting one item from the source to the destination. And Xij is the number of item transported from the source to the destination. So, I is the number of sources, it varies from 1 to m, and j is the number of destination which varies from 1 to n. And Sj is the subject to the constraint. So, we take the subject to the constraint, sigma j equal to 1 to n Xij is equal to Si for I equal to 1 to m. And another condition, sigma I equal to 1 to m Xij equal to Dj for j equal to 1, 2, 3 up to n, where Xij is always greater than 0, non-negative. Where Si is the supply capacity of the source I and Dj is the demand of the destination j. So, this is the mathematical expression of the transportation model. And the entire transportation model is given by the table. So, source points are 1, 2, 3, 4 up to m and destination points are 1, 2, 3, 4 up to n, and the supply capacity of the source. So, this is the source y. The supply capacity of the source is given on the right side of the table, s1, s2, s3, s4, s5, sm, and destination 1 to n. The demand of the destination is given here at the bottom of the table, last row demand D1, D2, D3, D4 and DN. So inside the cell, the cost coefficient, cost value, unit cost of transportation C11 is given, and the X11 is the number of items transported from the source 1 to the destination 1. Similarly here, from source 2 to the destination 2, this blue color line, from source 3 to the destination 3. And this blue color line C44, X44, so from the source 4 to the destination 4. So these are all the values given. So this X11, X12, X13 that we are going to allot to the number of items that we are going to transport from the one source to the one destination, that we are going to finalize in the solution methodology, solution procedure or solution method, and the cost matrix will be given. The cost matrix, transportation cost matrix will be given, supply capacity of each source is will be given in the problem, and demand requirement of each destination will be given in the problem. We have to transport the item from the source to the destination based on the requirement to minimize the transportation cost. And various definitions related with the transportation model. First definition is feasible solution. So, a set of non-negative values, what do you mean by non-negative values? Xij is greater than 0, always greater than 0, that satisfies the constraints is called as feasible solution to the transportation problem. So, what are the constraints here? The demand of the destination and the supply capacity of the source. Supply capacity of the source is restricted and demand of the destination is also known, is given in the problem. So we have to set, that is what the main constraint, the demand capacity, demand of the demand requirement of the destination and the source capacity of the source. The second definition is basic feasible solution. A feasible solution that contains m plus n minus 1 non-negative allocations is called as basic feasible solution to the transportation problem. M is the number of sources, that is number of horizontal rows. N is the number of destination, vertical columns. So, m plus n minus 1, number of allocations in the matrix, number of allocation in the cost matrix should be equal to m plus n minus 1. So, if you have m plus n minus 1 allocations in the transportation problem, then it is called as basic feasible solution to the transportation problem. Optimum solution. So, once you have the basic feasible solution, then you have to optimize. So, what do you mean by optimize? The minimum cost. So, the feasible solution that is said to be optimal if it minimizes the total transportation cost. So, when the cost is very minimum, then it is called as optimum solution. And there is one more type of problem, degenerate basic feasible solution. So, a basic, suppose we, in the earlier we said basic feasible solution, we require m plus n minus 1 non-negative allocations. Now, we have less than m plus n minus 1 non-negative allocation, then it is called as degenerate type of basic feasible solution or degenerate type of solution. So, a basic feasible solution that contains less than m plus n minus 1 non-negative allocations, it is said to be degenerate type of solution. So, we have to, there are certain problems with degeneration that we have to solve, that also we have to optimize, that kind of problem also we have to optimize. And the balanced problem, unbalanced problem. So, for balanced problem, the supply capacity of the source is equal to the requirement of the total requirement of the destination. So, if it is unbalanced type of problem, the supply capacity is not equal to demand. Right, supply capacity of the source is not equal to the destination, demand of the destination. This is also another type of problem. So, a simple problem and degenerate type of problem and unbalanced type of problem. These are all the different types of transportation problem available for solution. And we have to find the solution for all the cases. And the solution to the transportation model, there are three methods to calculate the, to find out the basic feasible solution. So, one is Northwest Corner method, least cost method and Werger's approximation method. So, first we have to understand the procedure to calculate the basic feasible solution. then we have to, after getting the basic feasible solution, then we have to go for optimization. There is a technique, there is a mathematical rule for optimization, and use the procedure, we have to optimize the solution. So that means we have to minimize the cost of transportation. Always optimization means minimizing the cost of transportation. So before we solve problem, before we take up the solution procedure, first we have to check, always we have to check the problem is balanced type of problem. So for balanced type of problem, total supply capacity of all the sources is equal to total demand of all the destination. That is the condition to begin the solution of the transportation model. So we take the northwest corner method. So here check that the problem is balanced type. So if the problem is not balanced type, then we have to balance the problem by adding the dummy row or the dummy column. We have to make the problem as balanced type of problem. Then start the left top corner of the matrix X11, the cell left top corner of the matrix X11 we have to start. If D1 is less than S1, so demand of the first destination is less than the supply capacity of the first source, set X11 equal to D1 and proceed horizontally to the right side. If D1 is greater than S1, so D1 is the demand of the first destination is greater than the source, capacity, then X11 equal to S1 and proceed vertically downward. If D1 equal to S1, the demand of the first point, first cell is equal to supply capacity of the first cell, then you set X11 equal to D1 and proceed diagonally. So this is the procedure. Then repeat this step. So when you reach the second cell, again you compare the whether when you move horizontally or vertically, then you compare again the supply and the demand and make the allocations. Repeat the procedure step 2 till you reach the right bottom corner in the matrix. So repeat the step by comparing the demand and supply of different cells up till the right bottom corner is reached. Then calculate the transportation cost of the problem. Fourth step is calculate the transportation cost of the problem. So we take up a numerical example to understand the procedure. So this is the cost matrix. The supply capacity is given. S1 equal to 400, S2 equal to 500, S3 equal to 600, S4 equal to 700, and the destination demand is also given. D1 equal to 700, D2 equal to 600, D3 equal to 500, D4 equal to 400. And the cost matrix is given. So we have to make the allocation using the least cost method. So once again we repeat the matrix again, and here the allocations are indicated by the blue color line, and the supply capacity, demand requirement is are given. The total supply is equal to total demand equal to 2200. The problem is balanced type of problem, and we can solve the problem using the least cost method. So in the least cost method, first we have to start from this corner X11. So we have to make the allocation here. So here, compare here. So the demand is 700 and the supply is 400. So we start from the cell X11. Demand D1 is greater than S1. Set X11 equal to 400 and go to the cell X21. So here S1 is 400. Supply, all the supply will be given to this cell, and we have to move vertically downward. Now coming to this cell X21, now we have to 21 is the cell we are now here. So here once the 400 is supplied here, the balance demand is 300. So here now the demand is 300 and the supply capacity is 500. Allot all the 300 here, the balance will be here 200. So the balance is 300 in which cell is less than S2. Now X21 equal to 300 and go to the cell X22. So you have to go to the cell X22. Now coming to the cell, now the supply capacity is 200 and here the demand is 200. You set the demand is 600. You supply all the 200 here and the balance will be 400 here, and the balance is 200, which is less than D2. set x22 equal to 200 and go to the cell x32. So, you have to go to the cell x32. Now, in this cell, now the 400 is the demand, and here what is available, 600 is available, right? So, you allot all the 400 here, allot all the 400 here and move horizontally to the cell x33 or 33 cell. So, now in this cell, the demand is now, supply capacity is 200, but the demand here is 500. So, you supply all the item here. So, now the demand is reduced to 300. Now, you move vertically downward. Now, once again, you have demand here is 300. So, supply capacity is 700. So, allot 300 here and move horizontally. And here the demand is 400 and the supply is 400. So, you satisfy here, allot all the 400 here. So, starting from here, so here the, so coming to the cell, the demand is 700, supply is 400, we supply all the 400 here, move vertically downward. Now, the demand here is 300, supply capacity is 500, you supply all the 300 here, move horizontally. And here the supply capacity is 200, demand is 600. So, supply all the 200 here, move vertically downward. Then, so coming to the cell, now the demand is 400, the supply capacity is 600. So, supply all the 400 here, supply the 400 and move horizontally. So, the destination, requirement for the destination is satisfied, move horizontally. Now, coming to the cell, the supply capacity is 200, demand is 500. So, supply all the 200 here. The balance demand is 300. Now, move vertically downward and here the demand is 300, supply capacity is 700. So, supply all the 300 here, the balance will be 400 and move horizontally. Here the demand is 400 and the supply capacity is 400 and it is supplied here, the condition is satisfied. So, this is what the northwest corner method and the transportation cost. So, everything is given here. The step-by-step procedure is given here and the transportation cost is calculated like this. XC11 into X11 plus C21 into X21 plus C22 into X22 plus C32 into X32 plus C33 into X33 plus C43 into X43 plus C44 multiplied by X44. So, substituting the numerical value 2 into 400 plus 3 into 300 plus 2 into 200 plus 3 into 400 plus 3 into 200 plus 4 into 300 plus 5 into 400 equal to rupees 7100. So, this is the transportation cost using the least cost northwest corner method. So, the next problem, next method is least cost method. So, in this method, the first allocation is made to the cell with the lowest cell value. Then the allocation is made to the second lowest cell value. The procedure is repeated till all the demand are satisfied and all the sources are exhausted. So, here we take another example, example number 2.2 to understand the least cost method. And here we have the 4 destination and the 3 sources. The demand capacity of the destinations are 600, 1000, 1200 and 1500. The supply capacity of the sources are 1100, 1300 and 1900. Now, the cost matrix is also given here. Now, we have to solve this problem, transportation problem using the least cost method. So, the problem is balanced type of problem. So, the total supply is equal to total demand is equal to 4300. It is a balanced type of problem and we have to make the allocation. Among the cell value, the lowest cost is 13, rupees 13. So, we have to make the first allocation here. So, where the demand is 1500 and supply capacity is 1100. So, all the 1100 product are supplied here and the balance on the demand equal to 400. So, 1100 is completely exhausted. The next cost value, next minimum cost is 14. So, we have to make the allocation here and this in this cell, the demand is 1200. Supply capacity is 13,300, you can satisfy all the demand and the balance will be 100. So, the source capacity is 100. The next minimum cost will be 17, rupees 17 and here we have to make the allocation where here the demand is 600, whereas the supply capacity is 100. So you supply all the 100 here. So here the D1, it is reduced to 500. Now the demand here is 500. The next lowest cost is 27. Next lowest cost is 27. Now here the demand is 1000 and the supply capacity is 1900. So all the thousands are satisfied. So and the balance will be 900. Next cost is 32. So the next allocation is 32 here. The demand is 500 and the supply capacity is 900. So all the 500 are satisfied. The balance will be 400. And finally, the final allocation is here, cost is 41, 6 is the allocation, 6th allocation is for the cost 41, where the demand is 400 and supply capacity is 400, that is completely satisfied. So there are 6 allocations and all the sources are, all the supply capacities of the sources are exhausted, all the demands were satisfied, so the problem is completed. Now the cost of transportation, overall cost of transportation, C14 into X14 plus C21 into X21 plus C23 into X23 plus C31 into X31 plus C32 into X32 plus C34 into X34, substituting numerical values, 13 into 1100 plus 17 into 100 plus 14 into 1200 plus 32 into 500 plus 41 into 400 equal to rupees 92,200. So this is the least cost method and we stop here. So we continue the lecture of solution procedure for the transportation model in the next lecture. And these are all the books I have published in mechanical engineering subject. There is one book, operation research book. You can refer to the book for additional problem in the transportation model. I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the videos for your better learning. So thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me for any clarification on the subject. So we'll meet again in the next lecture in the transportation model. Until then, bye bye.